Hey guys, I'm Tom the Tech Chap, and this is the new Razer Blade 15 Advanced. It's a stunning laptop with an Nvidia RTX 2080 Super Max-Q graphics card, 10th gen Intel i7, 4K OLED touchscreen, and it's one of a new breed of Nvidia Studio laptops. So Nvidia got in touch and asked if they could sponsor a video all about Nvidia Studio, and they teamed up with scan.co.uk, who kindly sent over this Razer Blade 15 Advanced, which is a studio certified laptop, for me to have a bit of a play with and really get to grips with what a studio laptop actually is. Because if you're anything like me, you've kind of heard of it and maybe seen this studio logo pop up a few times, but weren't really sure what it meant or what difference it makes. So long story short, and these studio laptops are designed for creators, essentially. People like me, I guess, because I'm a full-time YouTuber, as well as artists, designers, game developers, engineers, you name it. And here's just a few examples of the latest second-gen Nvidia Studio laptops, and there's more coming out all the time. So for a laptop to get that studio seal of approval, firstly, it has to have an RTX graphics card, so you get the best GPU acceleration, ray tracing, AI smarts, and the latest encoders for faster rendering and streaming. And that's why, for example, the Dell XPS 17 with an RTX 2060 Max-Q is a studio laptop, but the XPS 15 with a GTX 1650 Ti doesn't quite meet the standard. Secondly, the laptop comes with Nvidia Studio drivers installed, as opposed to their game-ready drivers, which I'll come back to in a second. And thirdly, it has to meet certain standards for specs and resolution, color accuracy, acoustics, connectivity, and even styling. Studio laptops are designed for creators as opposed to gamers. And while there is a lot of crossover, for example, a studio laptop would favor a 4K touchscreen over, say, a 300Hz 1080p display, which is the other option you have with this Razer Blade here, which makes sense for gamers, but this 4K OLED version covers 100% sRGB, 96% Adobe RGB, and 99% of the DCI-P3 color gamuts. So I can reliably edit my videos on it. My only complaint with this one is just how glossy and reflective that screen is. But at the core of Nvidia Studio, as you would expect, is that RTX graphics card. Now for me, I spend about half my life in Adobe Premiere Pro. And a recent update, version 14.2, made a massive difference to performance, as Premiere Pro now utilizes a lot more of the GPU rather than the CPU for certain tasks. And while this benefited nearly every PC with a graphics card, we see the biggest boost with an RTX card. So using the Razer Blade here, I rolled back to version 14 of Premiere Pro before the big update, and my 10-minute 4K project took 15 minutes and 8 seconds to export. Then updating to the latest version, the exact same project took just 8 minutes and 41 seconds to export. That's a whopping 75% faster. And looking at the performance monitor side by side, you can see before and after the difference in GPU utilization. And because RTX cards have a faster NVENC encoder based on their newer Turing architecture as opposed to the Pascal in older or lower tier GTX cards, like the 1650 or 1650 Ti you get in, say, the Dell XPS 15, in RTX laptops like this, we see the biggest improvement. And that encoder is also used in OBS and Twitch, so if you're a streamer, it's a big deal for you as well. So this is an example of GPU acceleration using the graphics card's CUDA cores and the faster encoder. But then there's the next-gen RTX enhancements. The RT cores for ray tracing and the Tensor cores for AI. DaVinci Resolve Studio also gets the RTX treatment with the speed warp feature that lets you speed up or slow down the clip, and facial recognition in scenes. In fact, we get RTX optimizations in over 50 creative apps, including most of the Adobe suite, video editors like Premiere Pro and DaVinci, 3D modeling in Blender, CATIA, Autodesk, even game design in Unity and Unreal. So this, you know, making videos is my full-time job. I absolutely love it and I'm incredibly lucky. And the improvements that I get from, you know, those export times, the enhanced detail feature in Lightroom, which comes in handy for me, and also being able to, you know, even edit 8K video in Premiere Pro, although it's a lot smoother in DaVinci Resolve. All that is awesome for me, but to be honest, it's only a fraction of what these RTX improvements can offer. And actually, the recent Adobe updates, together with the Nvidia Studio drivers, kind of make me reassess what I want in a PC or laptop in terms of specs, because I actually recently upgraded my desktop PC to a 32-core beast, which is crazy, but it didn't actually make that much difference to my Premiere Pro timeline or the export times, because so much of it is now put onto the GPU. Actually, buying a faster graphics card would be more valuable to me than a more powerful, crazy number of core processor. Now, the other big difference with studio laptops is they come pre-installed with Nvidia Studio drivers. Now, if you're a gamer and you have an Nvidia graphics card, then you'll be used to their game-ready drivers, which tend to be updated every couple of weeks or alongside a big game release. Whereas, studio drivers come out usually every 1 to 2 months. And the reason for that is Nvidia puts a lot more time into making sure it's stable and you're getting the performance you'd expect in a much wider range of programs. And it makes sense. I mean, the last thing you'd want if you're working on a project with a big team and then someone gets a driver update and it, you know, makes it incompatible or crashes. That's why Nvidia put a lot more time into QA testing their studio drivers with a much wider range of apps, including, you know, a lot of these creative professional applications, so that when you do get an update, it means that it's, you know, gonna work. You're not gonna have any problems. Although they do also incorporate the game-ready drivers, so you can still play games on this, which I'll come to in a second, but it just won't be quite as up-to-date as those dedicated game-ready drivers. Just for a bit of fun though, I jumped into Death Stranding, which has just come out on PC, and it uses Nvidia's DLSS 2 technology. I made a whole video about DLSS, and version 2 is incredibly impressive. For example, at 4K with ultra settings, I'm getting 43 FPS in Death Stranding. But then, with DLSS 2 enabled, it jumps up to an 82 FPS average. That's nearly double the frame rate, and it looks the same if not better than native 4K, which really goes to show the power of these RTX enhancements for both creators and gamers. Now, I'll be honest, it is easy to get jaded by these marketing and branding terms, but I think Nvidia Studio will genuinely make it easier for creative professionals, even people like me, who I don't really describe myself as a professional, but I do YouTube full time, so I guess I am. But it will help people, even if they're not particularly tech savvy, to buy a laptop that will be optimized for their needs. Plus, we're now seeing these second gen studio laptops that include Nvidia's latest RTX Super graphics cards, and more big brands are adding studio laptops to their lineup. They're all a bit different. For example, Acer's Concept D7 Easel supports Wacom pens for digital drawing, and ASUS's StudioBook 1 is the world's first laptop with a Quadro 6000 card. So it's still worth doing your research, but basically, Nvidia Studio means it's geared towards creators rather than gamers. Having a studio laptop can speed up my whole editing process. And knowing the laptop will also have a color accurate screen without me having to calibrate it myself is just one more thing I don't have to think about. And as more and more features and more creative applications are optimized for RTX with those sort of next gen Tensor cores and, you know, RT cores, then I think we're only just starting to see the real benefits of proper next gen GPU acceleration. So I hope you found that helpful, and if you are a kind of content creator yourself, whether you know you're a designer, an artist, a streamer, a gamer, a YouTuber, whatever you like, let me know what laptop you're using in the description below, whether you think an Nvidia Studio laptop would be up your alley, and if so, which one would you go for? So let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you want to see more from me, then don't forget to hit that little subscribe button below, and I'll catch you next time right here on the Tech Chat.